Mr. Kelso?
That's what the sign on the door says, miss.
Whoa, am I playing Kelso? That's awesome. Well, that's new. Huh, alright. Elsa late Leithman. Alright, pertaining to the matter of policy number blah 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 on the sudden death of Mr. Lewis Jan Buchwalter, I'm writing to inform you that you've been named sole beneficiary of his estate. Assembling check for $20,000, the maximum payable amount in accordance with clause. If you wish to dispute the settlement, you may contract
There's
our
no need
hours.
To come to the office, Ms. Lichtman. If you accept the settlement, all you need to do is sign here.
Yeah, here's the thing. I don't think she wants to. Clarence Fleming, claims assessor. California Fire and Life Insurance. Interesting.
I don't accept the settlement.
What do you mean you don't accept? I think you're pushing your luck, lady. This seems to be a ridiculously generous settlement. A $200 policy with a $20,000 payout? You should...
I don't want the money.
What do you mean you don't want the money?
I want you to investigate this case. I feel my friend may have been the victim of foul play.
Okay. Let me get the case file.
Okie dokie. What do we have here? Read entries and then press this to select.
There's got to be more in these files.
Alright, the development, obviously. Okay, here's the layout of the house. Blueprint of the house that he was in. Alright. Let's go on the top one. Property details. Subdivision. Surname against loss or damage not exceeding 900. Alright. And his insurance policy. How do I keep... There we go. Was killed on the roof of the property which he was working collapsed. Have an 830. Ascending the roof structure. Right himself by holding
Sounds
on...
Sounds like your friend took a hell of a fall. Sorry for your loss.
Yeah. The rafter broke of the ceiling rafter. Oh my god, and then the truss fell on him. Jeez Louise. Falling timber. Jeez Louise, Louise. That is not a fun way to go. Actually, any way to go is not a fun way, but this is particularly gruesome. Alright. Timothy Lee did the claims adjustment. Alright. Well, that's that.
Do you mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
Of course not.
Interesting. What evidence do we have? The settlement letter and the case file. Alright. This is really interesting. Alright. Well, I hope she tells the truth.
What basis do you have for your claim of foul play?
Lou Buckwalter was a craftsman. I don't believe he would have made a roof that would collapse.
Okay.
What are you talking
Damn
about,
it.
Ms. Lichtman? This was an industrial accident.
And then
How
she
do
looked
you
away
know
since
that?
I pressed truth.
Because it says right here in black and white.
Do you believe everything that you read, Mr. Kelso?
Dang it.
You and Buckwalter weren't married?
No.
And how did you become his beneficiary?
We were family friends.
I don't think she's telling the truth. Let's just wait. Yeah, there we go.
You expect me to reopen this case because you come in here walking that walk? Well, I'm not buying it. I think you should tell me what the hell is going on.
You really want to know?
Yes.
We were interned together on Ellis Island, resident alien Germans whose parents had been killed by Nazis. Do you see the irony in that, Mr. Kelso? We spent 4 years there.
Hmm.
So the roof collapsed. Accidents happen. What exactly are you trying to achieve here, Ms. Lichtman?
Exactly what I said. I want that building thoroughly investigated.
She probably does. There's something else. Is she gonna look away? Nope. Alright, let's go with truth on this one.
I'm intrigued, Ms. Lichtman. I really am. But you're going to have to give me something if you want me to get involved in this.
There is a conspiracy surrounding Elysian Fields and the new houses they are building. I believe your insurance company is involved.
That's pretty heady stuff, Miss Lichtman. Flimsy, but heady.
I've told you what I know, Mr. Kelso. What are you going to do about it?
All right, Miss Lichtman. One final question.
Yes.
What's your address?
Is that usual?
Is there anything usual about this case, Ms. Lichtman?
The address is on the letter, Mr. Kelso.
The address, not the phone number.
Oh, man. Oh, yeah, this can't go wrong. Oh, Kelso.
Mr. Benson would like to see you in his office, Jack. Upstairs. Come on, I'll walk you up.
Okay, just a second. I want to see if I have any outfits. No, I don't. Oh, well, that'd be kind of funny. Although, by the way, Flimsy but Heady was my nickname in high school. Oh, ho, ho, ho. I'm so funny. Alright, well, what do we have here, other than the usual craziness?
You drove me up to Mulholland, and we did some necking.
Yikes.
Someone ought to take him home. He's loaded.
Who's loaded? Me? I'm not loaded. I start drinking at 10 o'clock in the morning, thank you very much.
Mr. Benson, you wanted to see me?
Ah, yes, Jack. I'm just trying out a new putter. I noticed Elsa Lichtman in the lobby.
It's the weirdest thing, Mr. Benson.
Call me Curtis, Jack. This is California.
Like I said, Curtis, this is a very strange case.
How so, Jack?
That lady, Elsa Lichtman, is refusing a 20 grand payout.
Elsa Lichtman is hardly a lady, Jack. She's a jazz musician. Plays at the Blue Room in Hollywood. She has a fine pair of lungs, now that I think of it.
She's the beneficiary of this guy, Lou Buckwalter. He was killed in an industrial accident working for Elysian Fields Developments. You know Elysian?
I'm familiar with Leland Monroe. We move in similar circles.
Well, Ms. Lichtman is making some pretty serious accusations. She says the case stinks and that
she's something happened. She's a very highly strung girl, Jack. Strung out might be a better way to put it.
It's a pretty generous payment, Curtis. I think I should look into it.
Is there anything wrong with the paperwork, Kelso?
No, there isn't, Mr. Benson.
I didn't think so. Pay the case out and get her off our backs.
I can't make her take the money,
sir. Deal with it, Jack. Do your fucking job.
Yikes.
Do I have to do everything?
No, sir, you don't.
Fine, Jack. Fine. You know I have the greatest confidence in you.
Thanks, Mr. Benson.
Man, I freaking love that boss doing golf in his office trope. God, I love it so much. It's just so ridiculous. But it comes from somewhere.
Your car, Mr. Kelso.
Thank you.
Thanks, kid.
Oh, and I can just hold E to skip to my destination. How far away is it? You know what? Let's drive with Kelso, because I'm curious. I really am. See how he drives. See how this thing drives. This thing looks like a beaut. Alright. Gotta turn around. I'm not a police officer anymore. Out of my way. I'm an insurance adjuster. Out of my way, I'm important. I can totally do this. There we go. Perfect. Perfect. Out of my way, I make more money than you. say that. I can't say that if I'm a cop. Where cops get underpaid, for the most part. Which is why they're always so worried about their pension. Alright. I think one more street should do it. I wonder what... Whoa!
Watch it!
Who are you talking to there, Jackie boy? If I press F, nothing happens. That makes me sad. I don't have a siren on this thing. Lame. I wonder if I can hit as many people as I want.
Hey!
I really should be skipping to these destinations. I will next time. Well, come on, when's the last time we had a good smash? Not very many. Let's go through this playground. Woo! Yes! Insurance adjuster. Oh. Construction. Well, here's our good friend. Alright, here we go. Time to investigate the place in question. What do you know? We've been here before. Well, I've been here before. Old Jack hasn't. This is hilarious, and I love it. Hello? Hello? Girly calendar. And what do we have here? No one's here, so let's just snoop around. I love it. Alright, the cement delivery.
That's not how my pop taught me to mix it. Someone is cutting corners.
Ooh. Alright, received by someone who looks like Osterman? Yeah, Frank Osterman. On September 9th. Portland Cement. Base building sand. Alright, we want to talk to this Osterman fellow, I reckon. How do you know how to mix cement, Jack? Oh, what do we have here? And we have ourselves an order of demolition.
Bulldozing and starting again.
Any building work on the Normandy Avenue subdivision associated with the incident? So someone else knows that something's going on by the City of Los Angeles Department of Building and Safety.
Leland Monroe. Man with the grin. Looks like he doesn't like to be disappointed.
To Frank Osterman, delays will not be tolerated. So, looks like Mr. Osterman has a few, pressures on him, doesn't he? Oh, yes, he does. And what do we. I'm stuck. Oh, boy. Rancho. Ecandio or whatever. Alright. Great. Is there anything else? Maybe something here? No. Maybe something on this little... Nope, never mind. I thought there was something on that clipboard. No. Anything else over here? That looks important. This white thing. Nope, that also... No. We already know. The cement. I know. Okay, we're good.
Hey! You just can't be walking around down here.
I'm Jack Kelso, from California Fire and Life.
I don't care if you're from the Vatican. Buzz off!
I'm investigating the accidental death of a Lou Buckwalter, and...
You deaf? Do I have to beat on you?
Looks like you do.
You're
all
a
right.
Asshole.
Come on.
You know that?
Nice try.
I came to see the house where Lou Buckwalter died. You were just about to offer to show me the way.
It's out the gate and three houses down to the left. Don't know what you're looking for, smart guy. There's nothing there.
Then I'll poke around in the rubble.
Fine. As long as you're out of my sight.
Well, that guy went down in two hits. What a chump. Alright. Locations. Demolished house. How far away is it? It's like right around the corner. We'll just drive there. There we go. There it is, right there.
Ballrooms across America.
The place falls down and then they bulldoze it. What gives here?
A lot. Look, a red flag. Oh, look. Something not for construction use. Why won't you let to zoom in? That's it? You're not gonna say anything? Oh, come on. Really? Alright, let's try this one. Over here.
This guy must have escaped from the loony bin.
I did not escape from the loony bin, they let me go. Nothing. Not that I can see. A lot of stuff that says not for construction use. Feels like I'm missing something here. Well, I'm not leaving till I know for sure. Oh, maybe a third one? Who knows?
What's the rush? Time to survive the war for this?
Come on.
Let's try to piece this together.
Okay. No.
That's not right.
So it's obviously Keystone. So it's this bottom one. Keystone Films. What?
Keystone Films? Who gets their lumber from a film studio?
Yeah. That's a good question. Trying to kill you. What? Oh my god.
Son of a bitch.
Jesus. Oh no. Just slowed him down a little bit and then gone for it. Let's watch this again. This is hilarious. I'll show you. I'll run you over. Jesus! Alright. Time to stop. Whoa, what? Okay. Third time's a charm. If it takes more than a few tries, then I'll stop recording until something a little more interesting happens. God, that's funny, though. Just the idea of this. Like, you think he's gonna get away with this? He's gonna just bury the body afterwards? They're witnesses. Alright.
Son of a bitch.
Alright. Go for it. Keep going. Aw, shit, you're right. Keep going.
Come on, Jack.
Go for it. Go. Don't leave. Beat him up. No, don't leave. Oh my god. What? That's attempted murder, Jack. You can't take that line down. Trace the address of Keystone Films. Okay. How's this gonna work?
You're listening to KTI Radio.
Alright. Just gonna block that intersection. No big deal. Thank you.
Jack Kelso, California Fire and Life Investigator. I need an address on the Keystone Film Company.
The address is 658 North Wilton Place. Is there anything else?
No, thank you, ma'am.
I love this. I'm Jack Kelso. I'm a fire and life insurance investigator. Quick, get me some news! Get me an address! Alright.